Within the Fortis system, we like to run everything off the patient profile. We find it makes it a lot easier for not only you, but your staff as well, to be able to track payments and run payments, and then you can add cards under a patient's profile. And now everything for that patient happens within one location. So whether it be finding a payment or running a payment or keeping a card stored on file, makes it so much easier to do that within the patient profile. So what we'll do is we'll have you create the contacts. Now, if this is your first time, if you have like a spreadsheet of all your patients, we can actually upload that for you automatically. Otherwise, let's say you've got those all uploaded or you just want to come manually do it. You come here and click the contacts button, and then you can just click add contact, and then we'll go ahead and punch in their information. Phelps, you don't need an account number unless you want one. Email address, I find important because it makes life a lot easier when you're trying to email receipts to have an email in there. Most patients we find like the email receipts feature, and it makes your life a lot easier and less printing. We do want to punch the address in here. It is used for the credit card that will be on file. You can always change it when you're adding the credit card, but you kind of want their default home address. And then if you want home, cell phone, any of that information, you can see here you can automatically set up to email transaction receipts. So if you want this patient to automatically receive transaction receipts, you can come in here and select this. It's done at the patient level. Otherwise, you can just manually email out the receipts as they're requested. So then you can go ahead and say, well, let me show you one other thing while we're in here. There is a header message that can come up. So if at any point you want to set a reminder, whether it be a pop-up or a banner that shows up for a patient, you can add a reminder in here, and then when it comes into their profile, you will see that there. But we'll go ahead and save that contact. Oh, I forgot to select the location. I have more than one location in here, so if you are a multi-location office, that's what this is for. By default, it should have your location automatically selected. So we'll see that contact was added. It automatically comes in here and creates the profile. And then from here, you can do all the things you need to do, like click the charge card button and swipe a card one time, store it, you know, credit cards or bank accounts on file, set up your reoccurrings, everything. So everything's done right here from the profile. When you log in, it automatically takes you to the virtual terminal screen. You can run transactions from here, but we recommend running them under the patient profile because then you know exactly who that transaction belongs to, and everything's under one profile for that patient. So it makes it a lot easier when you're ever doing research. You can come back in here, and let's go to like John Smith, someone who's got a lot of transactions. You'll see within John Smith's profile, we've got a lot of transactions in here. And so that we can, you know, if I ever need to find any information on John Smith, I've got all his information right here. So all of his bank accounts and credit cards are on file. All of his transactions and reoccurrings are right here as well. So that's why we recommend to run it within the patient profile.